Hello, my name is Crystal Hill here. I'm one of the support technicians here at the Hostmasters, and I'm going to be going today because only thing that you said was that your radio was not connecting. You wasn't very specific as what is not, is it not connecting, what is it connecting to. So I asked, when you do raise a support ticket, please be specific so we'll know particularly how to help you. So I'm just going to go in here and see what I could see that's possibly not connecting. Okay, so I'm going to go over here to the server there and log in. Leave your own net server. Let's see. BVSC. Bucking Flames. Okay, this is you. Well, obviously, you haven't turned on your radio station. So I'm going to log into that. Okay, as I see right now, your station is not on. Okay, you have an intro song there. Alright, so we'll just use that to start your station. You do have to have one song uploaded in order to start your station. So now I'm going to go in and we're going to start your station. As in your training videos, in order to start a station, you need to go to playlists. You need to create a playlist. So we're just going to name this Station Start. Okay. Enable, general rotation, random. I always put this at 18. Active, you can, this is important too. So you can put A, just make sure it says AM to PM is unlimited, and press save. Okay. Now we're going to go to media. That is right here. Under the auto DJ, in the center is a media button. You press that as in your thing. Now you're going to be able to see the music that has been uploaded. Obviously, this music is not properly tagged. So since it's not properly tagged, it's going to appear as unknown. The artist will appear as unknown. The song will appear as unknown because the metadata is not complete. But your title will show. You have to bring the song into your start folder. Okay, once you have done that, on the bottom, if you, this little thing right here, if you open here, you're gonna see where it opens up. Oops, I'm sorry, it's not opening up on mine. There you go. And it should say, like, you gotta click on Station Start. You have to click on the folder. Okay, because this is where the system pulls your music from, and you're gonna press save. Once you have pressed save, and again, all of this is in the in the training tutorials when you go through them. Now you're ready to start your station, okay? Now that you're ready to start your station, we press Station Start, okay? And it has your, and the only thing that's going to be playing is what's in that folder. And it says stream started successfully. If I go over here and I go to click, it's the, whatever your intro song is. I'm just gonna press play, and I should be able to hear whatever is playing. Okay. And since I'm late. Okay, sound like some quartet type music. All right. So if you go to quick links here, you're gonna get your streaming server link, which is here. Okay. So you can always copy this and to verify that this is playing in the browser. It's the Shoutcast V2.
Yes, I do feel better, y'all.
Okay, so your intro mix thing is up and it is playing. If we click right here, this, of course, I'm not going to go over this because this is in the training. As well, you have to go to your server login, and it shows you in the training videos how to register for Shoutcast. That's in the group, okay? And that's how you register for Shoutcast. Now, the other part is being able to go live. Alright, so it looks like you did your name, whatever, you know, you set this up. I'm going to set up a name and a username to go live. So, because a lot of people get confused on that, or I guess for whatever reason, I'm not clear in my instruction. So, go clearer again. So I'm gonna go in chorus, I'm gonna create a username, admin Crystal, then put me a password. Okay. I'm gonna give myself all the permissions, etc. Alright. I'm gonna press save. There. Alright. So, when you're going live, there are a bunch of different programs that you can use. Me personally, you're on a Mac, so I'm on a Mac as well. I use audio, this program called Audio Hijack. Okay? But whatever you use, you can, it's called Audio Hijack, and I believe it's like $69 or something like that. I don't know how much it costs because I've had it for forever. Okay, yeah, there we go. You can try it for free, but it's only gonna let you do a couple of minutes. It's $59. All right, so whatever it is, this is ultimately what you need. So when I go over here, I'm gonna open it up. I'm gonna open up Audio Hijack, which I should have down here. I thought I did. I guess I didn't. I'm gonna open it up. This is not meant to teach you how to use this or whatever, because again, you could always YouTube it. You know, I'm not responsible for broadcasting software. I'm only responsible for streams. So, but basically in a session, you go to new session, and it's gonna ask you what you want to do. Okay, you're gonna broadcast to the internet radio. You're gonna press that and then choose. Once you have done that, there it's going to give you like your application. So if you want to play your music from iTunes, or you can put whatever application you want to play for, they have tons of tutorial. It's their stuff on there. Okay, now my input device, what I'm going to use is my what you call this thing that I'm on, my mixer or whatever. Okay, so right here. And then output is, you can have it go into your headphones, which is what I'm going to have the output going, so I can monitor exactly what is going on. This is the part that everybody, that there is like, oh, I don't know what to do, yada, yada, yada. So you click on it and you go to setup. The server type you're going to put is Shoutcast 1, because you have to use the Shoutcast 1 information to do that. If you go to quick links right here, and you go down to, it's going to tell you how to connect live when Auto DJ is running. It gives you everything right here. And how to connect to Auto DJ live when it is not run. You know, when it's not running. Like if you wasn't running Auto DJ. Everybody runs Auto DJ, so that's not really important. What's important is this right here, where it says when Auto DJ is running. It said the it tells you the protocol that you're going to use is Shoutcast, blah, blah, blah. It gives you the server host name, which you're just going to copy here on the server host. Let me go back into Audio Hijack. Server address, you're going to press paste. I mean, you're going to put what you have there. Your port number, which is 8126. You're going to copy that there. And you're going to press, put the port number on there. And then your password is your Auto DJ name, which I just forgot it, whatever I set up. See my Auto DJ name, which is Lady Hell. So my Auto DJ name is, I mean, not Lady Hell, it's Admin Crystal. So it's Admin Crystal, and then you put a colon, and then you put your password. Okay, it's your username, a colon, which is the dot dot thing, and your password. So my password is, all right, so the format, it has to be spoken word. I mean, not spoken word, sorry. Medium quality, which should be at 128. If you want to do advanced settings, you need to put a constant bit rate of 128 kilobits. Okay, you can do 441 or whatever. You can do auto 441. I mean, just depending on how technical you want to be. What's this? And the block title is just the name of your station. So I think it's Bukin Radio or something. All right, so now that we have that going on, I'm going to switch the thing to, because I use Spotify, just some music that I'm that I typically play. Oh, why it's not letting me choose it? I guess I got to go on there and pick it. Open. All right, that is so crazy. Maybe because it was open, it's not letting me click. It normally does. Alright, we're gonna delete this. Turn off this block. Delete this block. So I'm just gonna come over here and go to pick a new one, because for some reason it just wanted me to. Okay, there we go. So I selected my Spotify. You got your meter. These are your sources, your meters. This is what's, you know, this is what's going in. This is what's going out. And then in here, to turn your volume on and off, you're going to need to put in, like, you know, the volume thing to control the volume. Again, they have whole tutorials on here. Personally, it's not my software. So, yeah, I don't do all that. But this is to turn my USB. This controls the volume to my microphone, right? So this is just a basic setup. Oh yeah, and if you wanted to record your live show, then basically you just you put the recorder there, you click on it, and then you click right here and you tell it where you want it to, you know, where you want it to save to. And I might want to save it to my desktop, and I want to put, you know, my desktop, and I'm just going to create a new folder. Once I create a new folder, that's just going to say live live shows. So I know where it's going to save to. Okay, so everything that's coming through there, that's what it's going to save to. All right, so now we have everything set up like so. Again, like I said, this is, I don't own this software, but I use it and I love it. And I've been using it for a while now. Okay. And then, so the only thing we have to do now is, now that this is on, so now that this is on, I'm just going to say record. Alright, and it's connecting to your radio station there, and it's live. So I'm just going to go over here to my new songs. God is good. Okay, so then I'm a broadcast. It's gonna be like this. Hello and thank you for tuning to Bukin Radio. This is Lady Helen. We are live all the way from Frisco, Texas. So tune in as we prepare to just bless the Lord in songs, and this artist is off track.
Okay, God, keep flexing. Yeah. Mama told me, mama, all the time.
God is good. All the time.
Mama told me, mama, all the.
Now, if I turn the headphones off, I'm not monitoring it. So then, when I go into, let me turn the audio capture on, where you'll be able to hear the audio that's coming into the screen. So 1 second, let me. Yeah, I think it's on anyway. So now, cool. So now when I play on the radio, it should be playing. Yeah, whatever I'm playing. And what, however I'm live.
I've been up for like 2 weeks, grinding in the daytime. Jimmy Fallon while you sleep, digging roots on the late night. Staying trill, absolutely.
Okay, so now, not for sure. I hope I answered all the questions within that. Again, all this information slowed down and explained and all that is inside the thing. So you have to tell me exactly what's not connecting. Because the live is connecting, your radio station is on, so I'm not for sure what's not connecting. Okay?